Hello everybody, this is Tiziano and today we're getting to play with ARUCO Markers. Hey, but before we go, I want to thank Tom Pittenberg from the Autopilot development thing for this awesome keyring, you see? Autopilot, remove pilot before flight, awesome. And if you guys want to buy one of those, just check out the Autopilot web store right here where you can find t-shirts and caps and you get to sustain the Autopilot community. Hey, if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. I'll be posting content about robotics, drones, programming, OpenCV right here. But now, let's get to the tutorial. There are several examples of precision landing and hovering out there with ARUCO markers, like this one from Good Robots. But in a couple of videos, we're gonna get to write our own script for hovering above a target. If you wanna know more about ARUCO markers, just check out the OpenCV webpage. As for now, it's enough to know that number one, one marker is enough for estimating the camera position and rotation. Number two, a marker is identified by the dictionary it belongs to. Number three, there are multiple dictionaries out there. In this tutorial, we're gonna stick with the original one and we're gonna create our marker from the online generator of the University of Maryland right here. If you haven't seen my video about setting up the Raspberry Pi with OpenCV and calibrating the camera, don't miss it. I put a link in the description below. If you remember, the last video we set up OpenCV with extras and ARUCO is one of the extra libraries that we installed. In fact, this video is actually inspired from the example provided in the library itself, but I felt like a step-by-step procedure would be more helpful for anybody that is dealing with this matter for the first time. And now, let's talk about reference frames. The camera reference frame is centered in the camera optical center, with the z-axis sticking out, the x-axis going right, and the y-axis going down. The ARUCO marker instead has the z-axis coming toward you, the x-axis going right, and the y-axis going up. So, if you think about that, when you face the camera and the ARUCO marker, the two reference frames are one opposite to the other. And that's why we're gonna define a flip reference frame about which we're gonna define our rotations. That's right, that's because I don't wanna have a 180 degrees roll when I face the camera with the ARUCO marker. Now, I think it's enough for talking, so follow me in the next tutorial. Let's get started by importing NumPy, CV2, and then the ARUCO library from CV2, and then sys, time, and math. Then we get to define the ID that we want to track, and the marker size in centimeters. Then we load the camera calibration, such as the camera metrics and the camera distortion. If you don't remember how to get them, just check out my video about OpenCV, I put the link in the description below. Now here we define the 3x3 rotation matrix around the x-axis, and as you see, I have the x equal to 1 and y and zeta equal to negative 1, so they are flipped. Next step, we define the ARUCO dictionary we're going to use, in my case, is the ARUCO original. Next step is capturing the video, in this case I'm capturing the camera. Be sure that you set the camera width and height that you use during the calibration procedure. Now here I'm reading the camera, but you can also read a video or a picture. And now the main loop. First, we read the camera frame. Then we convert in grayscale using CVT color with the option BGR to gray. Remember that in OpenCV, images are stored in blue, green, red. And now the main function detect markers from the library ARUCO, where we pass our gray as image, our dictionary and the parameters, and then we pass our camera calibration as camera metrics and camera distortion. As an output, we're gonna have the corners, the IDs, and the rejected. If we find our tag in the IDs array, then we use the method estimatePostSingleMarkers, passing the corner, the marker size, and the camera calibration. The output ret is gonna be an array of arrays that contains the rotation and position of each identified marker. Now, because we're gonna have only one marker, we're gonna just check out the first entry in those arrays, but you guys can do something more advanced than that. The first thing we're gonna do is draw detected marker, and then we draw the axis that you're gonna see. It's pretty cool. It will show up in the frame in a few seconds. Then we just show the frame, and then we set up Q from our keyboard to quit the process. And here the result, you see, pretty impressive. Let's put some text on the image. So let's print the marker position respect to the camera frame. We create a string and then we put text on the frame.
And here we go. These are the coordinates of the marker with respect to the camera frame. And you see, if I move in and out, the zeta changes accordingly. Now let's obtain the rotation matrix by using the method Rodriguez from CV2. RCT is the rotation from tag to camera. If I want to estimate the Euler's angles, I'm going to use these functions here that I'm going to just paste in the script. If you want to find this function, you can find them on learnopencv.com rotation matrix to Euler angles. I put a link in the description below. And now let's get the attitude in terms of Euler 3-2-1. Using the function rotation matrix to Euler angle. So let's create the string where we put the Euler's angles and we put the text on the image. And here we go. So in this moment, you have to imagine that the attitude is measured respect to the flipped camera reference frame. Now let's get the camera position and attitude with respect to the marker. This is very useful, especially because our robot will have the camera and we're gonna estimate the robot pose from the marker. As you see, this is the camera position respect to the marker. So you have to imagine that the marker now is steady and the camera is moving. In my case, of course, I'm moving the marker for obvious reasons.
Okay, so that wasn't hard at all, and as usual, you get to find the source code in my GitHub page right here. And if you guys think that you need an extra help on reference frames and Euler's angles, quaternions, just write it down in the comments below, and if I have enough interest, I'll set up a video for you. So don't miss the next step where we're gonna have our virtual drone hovering above a target. We'll get to put together all the lessons learned so far, so if you haven't seen my previous videos, I put a link in the description below. Don't miss them, we're gonna be using every single one of them. Don't forget to subscribe, and for now I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.